Key findings from the 2015 Kenya Malaria Indicator Survey. The 2015 Kenya Malaria Indicator Survey, or KMIS, is the third malaria indicator survey to be carried out in Kenya. 6,481 households and 5,394 women aged 15 to 49 were successfully interviewed in the 2015 KMIS. This represents a response rate of 97% for households and 97% for women. All children aged 6 months to 14 years living in selected households were eligible for anemia and malaria testing. Anemia testing was carried out using the HemoQ system. Malaria testing was done through both rapid diagnostic testing, also known as RDT, as well as blood smear microscopy. Of the 10,721 eligible children, 93% provided blood for anemia, 93% for RDT, and 93% for malaria microscopy. Malaria prevalence estimates in this video are based only on microscopy results. The 2015 KMIS provides estimates at the national level, urban-rural areas, and for 5 malaria epidemiologic zones: highland epidemic, lake endemic, coast endemic, semi-arid seasonal, and low risk. The results of the 2015 KMIS show that progress has been made in malaria prevention and case management since 2010. Currently, 63% of households in Kenya have at least one long-lasting insecticidal net, or LLIN. This is an increase since 2010, when only 44% of households owned an LLIN. Although ownership of LLINs is widespread throughout Kenya, only 4 in 10 households have enough LLINs to cover each household member, assuming one LLIN is used by 2 people. Among the household population, 53% have access to an LLIN, while less than half, 48%, slept under an LLIN the night before the survey. Children under 5 and pregnant women are the groups most vulnerable to malaria. Currently, more than half of both children under 5 and pregnant women slept under an LLIN the night before the survey. Use of LLINs by both children under 5 and pregnant women has increased since 2010. Malaria during pregnancy contributes to low birth weight, infant mortality, and other complications. To prevent malaria, pregnant women living in malaria-endemic areas should receive 2 or more doses of SP-funded during an antenatal care visit. More than half of pregnant women received this intermittent preventive treatment, or IPTP, during an antenatal care visit. IPTP in malaria-endemic areas has increased fourfold, from 14% in 2007 to 56% in 2015. Fever is a major sign of malaria in children. Overall, 36% of children under 5 had a fever in the 2 weeks before the survey. 72% of children with fever sought advice or treatment, while only 39% had blood taken from a finger or heel stick for testing. Artemisinin-based combination therapy, or ACT, is the recommended drug for treating malaria in children. Among children with fever who received an antimalarial, 92% received ACT. Only 1% of children aged 6 months to 14 years are severely anemic. Prevalence of severe anemia is highest among children living in the lake endemic zone, 2%. In Kenya, 1 out of 10 children aged 6 months to 14 years tested positive for malaria by microscopy. Malaria prevalence varies greatly by malaria endemicity zone. Malaria prevalence is highest in the lake endemic zone, where approximately 3 out of 10 children aged 6 months to 14 years tested positive for malaria. Malaria prevalence is lowest in the low-risk zone, at less than 1%. Malaria prevalence has decreased from 11% in 2010 to 8% in 2015. Malaria prevalence has also decreased in the lake endemic zone from 38% in 2010 to 27% in 2015. As you can see, the 2015 Kenya Malaria Indicator Survey provides a wealth of information about malaria in Kenya. Results of the survey show where progress has been made, as well as areas for improvement. The 2015 KMIS provides data to inform strategic planning and program evaluation in Kenya. The 2015 KMIS was implemented by the National Malaria Control Programme of the Ministry of Health and the Kenya National Bureau of Statistics from July to August 2015. Funding for the KMIS was provided by the Government of Kenya with support from the United States Agency for International Development, the United States President's Malaria Initiative, the Global Fund, the World Health Organization, the United Kingdom Department for International Development, and the United Nations Children's Fund. ICF International provided technical assistance as well as funding to the project through the DHS program. For additional information on the results of the 2015 KMIS, please contact the National Malaria Control Programme in Kenya and the DHS Programme in the United States.